Hi, y'all. This message is going to be somewhat raw in tone, deliberately. It was downloaded into me this morning, fresh off the press. It's mainly addressed to whom it concerns who are being abused, or perhaps you know someone who is being abused and you might want to share this message with them. And it's also addressed to the abusers. Now, it's going on YouTube, which is open to the public observation, and some who may observe may be in the category of abusers, and they will likely not be pleased with my message. I say to you, I don't give a fuck. You don't give a fuck about being abusive, so why should I give a damn about offending your ass? But before I get into the meat of my message, I wanted to share about a true life story that I saw last night that involved a relationship triangle. A husband, a wife, and a man who the husband thought was his friend. However, that proved not to be true because he was fucking his wife. She indicated after some weeks, she claimed it was some weeks, that she was done with the affair and she was going to get back into good graces with her husband. So one night, they were in the bed together and lo and behold, a knock came on the door about midnight and it was Lover Man. And he came to confront the woman and wanting her to make a choice between him and the husband. The husband answered the door, one thing led to another, and when all was said and done, the husband stabbed the man 32 times, which was considered overkill. But also, some folks can understand because the husband was in a state of rage due to the circumstances. But that doesn't justify that he stabbed the man 32 times, and the arresting officers indicated to him that he would be charged with murder due to the indication of the overkill method of killing. But Colorado has some kind of law in place that indicates when someone comes to your home in a threatening manner that the killer is justified in killing the quote-unquote intruder. So the husband got off. However, obviously the universe didn't agree with the man-made system's form of justice that was administered because 14 years later the husband was once again involved in a triangle and he was shot dead in the parking lot. That was the manner of justice that the universe considered to be appropriate. Justice, people, is not always swift, but certainly it is solid and sure. So now to move on to my message to the whom it concerns who are being abused. Your time has arrived, your season has come, where you are about to have the escape hatches unloosed for you to get out of your life of depression, despair, and anguish. It is time for you to be butterflies. Yes, freedom awaits, and you will experience levels of peace in your lives that you've never experienced before because you are going to get away from your abusers. It is ended for you. Yes, the time has certainly come for you to breathe air that doesn't have fear in its content. And to the abusers, I say this. You have been given an opportunity, as I speak, by the universe to correct your wayward abusive conduct. To get your account cleared, you need to apologize to your victims, compensate them, and recompense them for their time with you that involved mistreatment, verbal, physical, mental, and sexual abuse in some cases. Yes, you can tell them you're sorry, but you need to show them at length that you are sorry and fix what the fuck you messed up. And if you do that, you will have some mercy shown to you by the universe. Now, if you elect to continue in your current abusive postures, what do you have to look forward to? Well, I can tell you, some of you all will get fired from your jobs. Some of you all will have diseases to enter you. Some of you all will have increased nightmares. Some of you all will have levels of anguish and dismay similar to what you placed upon others. And I'm not just blowing air because I have lived this in my personal life. I had a situation years ago where I was being abused by a guy. It wasn't physical, it was more verbal and mental. And I wrote him a letter and I let him know if he continued to abuse me, he was going to have health harmful issues. He was going to have job problems. And it wasn't even a month before what I put in that letter came true, because he decided he was going to buck the system and defy what was logical. So he got fired from his job. He got disease placed upon him. He called me and said, asked me if I put a curse on him. I said, no, I didn't put a curse on you. I told you if you don't do this, this is going to happen. And so you decided to just more or less snub your nose at my helpful advice. And so you got what you had coming. He had a chance to clear his account and to fix his fucked up shit. He chose not to, so oh well. So again, abusers, if I were you, I would take this advice and do a 360 and turn from whatever you're doing that is belittling to others, bullying to others, because if you don't cease it, the universe, I can assure you, will deliver some unpleasant consequences your way in multiple measures. So I want to say once again, congratulations to those who are being abused, who have ended that chapter in your book, and you are going to write new pages, and you're going to fly free. I congratulate you, and I just hope that the abusers are wise enough to listen and to apply what is necessary and suitable and in order to clean their slates. Or, as the saying goes from back in the day, check yourself before you wreck yourself, because the wrecking ball is headed your way if you stay in that current abusive posture. Thank y'all for listening. Bye now. Oh, I did want to add this part. And of course, I'm not just talking about men, because there are women who are abusive as well. It's not a gender-specific message. It's to whosoever the damn shoes fit, okay? Male or female. But I did want to say this as far as to the men who use women as punching bags. You are punks and cowards, because on the average, women cannot give you a physical match competition. So there's nothing impressive or cool or smooth about using women as punching bags. If you really want to impress somebody, if you really want to be a man, how about if you go toe-to-toe with some men who are like the physique of Mike Tyson, say? Yeah, they could really give you a run for your goddamn money. How about that? No, you don't want to do that, though. You want to do something to women who are typically physically less in strength than you are. Miss me with the bullshit, with that coward, wuss-ass posture, with those postures that go against women. And also, calling women bitches. That word bitch is so overused. I believe some folks use that word because they have a limited vocabulary and they can't think of shit else to say but bitch. I got your bitch, boy. For real, for real. Real men don't call women bitches, because women are precious. And even women who are not acting like they got good damn sense don't need to be called bitches. But every now and then, you may find justification for doing so. But that's probably rare, few and far between occasions. But I'm not going to dispute that, because that's not that big a deal. But I thank y'all for listening. Bye now.